both past and present elders and to Aboriginal people present here tonight. So remember, the thing about the annual awards is that there's always something special in terms of what we actually present. So in one country here in Australia, we call it the thong. But of course, Lisa, in another place, it's something different, isn't it?
Yes, so coming from the States, when I was told that the winners will be awarded thongs, that means something else in the States. But I'll leave that to your own imagination. We're also very excited that for our fifth annual NEWi Awards, it is in a limited edition black thong flip-flop that will match with any of your outfits. Quite slimming as well, too.
Hence, we're channeling the theme here, black and white. So at this stage, there's a couple of things we'd like you to be doing as well during the event. There's a social media. What's our hashtag?
Absolutely. When you're out taking your photos by the media wall or throughout the evening, please use hashtag 2015 NEWi Awards.
And also, tonight's been live streamed by Hunter TV, and we've also been entertained with Chuck's fantastic light show. And remember, Chuck's also part of an event that's happening here called the, it will come to me in a moment, but it's a great event with the emerging writers and young people in this town. And his events are being on tonight as well. But this stage in the room, we've been joined by investors, our political representatives, and also some people from our top agencies, and along with entrepreneurs and innovators, which is a real acknowledgement of the awards and what it's actually been meaning to do for the Hunter and for this region over the last 5 years. But this stage, tonight, is all about those people who have done some outstanding work, and we want to acknowledge the nominees and the winners tonight. So in our round one, Lisa?
Absolutely. So without further ado, let's begin the awards. Our first category is Best Live Streaming of the Year, and we invite Greg Fenwick from Newcastle City Council to present the awards.
So the live webcast of the Burton Automotive Pro and Burton Automotive Motive Women's Classic was sponsored by Newcastle Now and produced by 180. Web analytics for the period February 15 to February 22, there were 596,000 page views. In the next category.
All Sports Show, a weekly live production with four panelists interviewing local sporting guests.
And that included panelists Darren Ford, former NRL Knights player, Ivan Spez, General Manager of Game Development for Cricket New South Wales, and Kurt Finlay, who I believe is joining us here tonight, Olympic gold medalist, and Brett Keeble, sports journalist of the Newcastle Herald.
Our third nominee is Bar TV.
And Bar TV has really been a disruptor. So for those in the broadcast sports area, Bar TV has basically been capturing the local sports event and broadcasting into any venue that basically has an IP connection. That is a television, pubs and etc. So they're real disruptors. So to announce our winners of the three categories, I call on Greg. Now first up, Greg, I want to ask you a question.
Yeah.
Innovation, Newcastle, smart cities. Is it an oxymoron?
12 months ago, I would have agreed with you. But over the last couple of months, the smart city complex equation in Newcastle is really coming together. There's a lot of partners now wanting to do smart city in Newcastle, and I really think that the next 2 to 3 months will set the pace because we've got some wonderful citywide partners that are really supporting the smart city concept.
So it goes back to that whole collaboration process that is obviously rich. But what are the obstacles really at this stage?
Well, to talk about an event that was on earlier today, which was the Smart City Conference over at City Hall, They said that you can't have a smart city without smart people. I think this room is a great way to say we've got plenty of smart people, so let's get the smart city going.
Okay.
Absolutely.
So, Lisa?
Without further ado, will you announce the winner?
I even get to open the envelope.
Absolutely.
Right, so it's between Surfest, which we've known and loved for 30 plus years, the All Sports Show, which is a new product, and Bar TV, which is just going from strength to strength.
But the winner is?
I'm happy to announce that Surfest is the winner of this award.
So we'd like to invite the Surfest team to come up and accept the award.
The Surfest team and media, social media guru is here to say a couple of words.
Thank you very much. I'm very proud to accept this award on behalf of Surfest. It is 30 years old, 31 next year. We like to think we're part of Newcastle and...
Big loud voice.
Sorry, like to think we're part of Newcastle and the NEWi Awards have just given us a real boost. As we go into our 31st year next year, it's going to be bigger and better, and hopefully we can win another one next year. Thank you very much.
Absolutely. Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you. Greg. So coming up, we have the best mobile application of the year. We have best government solution of the year. Best online news publication of the year, and then the fifth one, best social media solution campaign of the year. We're just going back to our second category.
Yep.
Lisa.
So, sponsored by GrowthWise, can we ask Alan Spicer to please come up on stage?
Now, Alan, tell me, what's your favourite superhero character? Because as those who don't know, GrowthWise, led by Stephanie Hines and the rest of the crew, they decided to take on all these kind of super characters. And what's yours in specifically, Alan?
Well, the answer to both is simple. I'm Superman, so Superman's favourite was easy for me. Look after superannuation, so... Easy choice.
Good linkage.
Okay, so Lisa, where do we go from here?
So the nominees for Best Mobile Application of the Year is Stats One App by Smart Sports. Newcastle Infrastructure Group. Take Five App by Newism. 365 app Maroons, and Psych Torque app by Motorcycle Publishing.
Okay, so in those categories we had a number of groups. So Star One endeavours to bring 2015 technology to any new young player who wishes to track and analyse his or her performance. Star One's apps collects football players' match statistics using advanced visualisation tools. These stats are then displayed on the player's account in Stats One's web platform. Lisa?
Newcastle Coal Infrastructure Group's Take 5 app is a app that provides a tech-savvy workforce with an innovation, efficient, and accessible way to perform a self-risk assessment before commencing a task. The primary goal of the app is to increase submission rates by further supporting and encouraging workers to take responsibility for their own safety and the safety of those around them.
And then 365 Cups app, which is a combined development between a number of councils. How great it would be to order coffee from a smartphone to avoid lines and wait. developing and funding the project in-house, 365 Cups launched in January 2011. 365 Cups have quickly grown to become a complete smart ordering platform for businesses ranging from regional cafes to national franchise.
SykeTorque's app is where most print magazines are making token efforts to provide a digital version of their print pages. SykeTorque actually built a product which suits the size of the screen and the capabilities of those devices, with integrated modern ideas such as sharing to make the experience of reading and watching on an iPhone a better experience than picking up a magazine or going to the website simply.
So, to announce your winner, Alan?
The winner of Best Mobile App for this year is Maroons for 365 Cup App.
They weren't able to be here, but in fact, are they being Skyped in now? Yes, they're joining us. Please, hello. Welcome.
Hello. Hi.
Thanks for joining us. Congratulations.
Thanks for having me by Skype.
So, to whom are we speaking?
It's Simone from 365 Cups.
Thanks, Simone. What was the one thing you found really fun about making or designing this application?
I think for me it was just I love coffee, I love tech, and you know, just putting it together, and lucky for me, a whole other bunch of other people, thousands and thousands and thousands of people now love that solution too. So we've been going for a while now, and the system's always evolving, so it's really exciting to be here today and to receive this award. And you know, we've got a lot of clients in regional areas and up in Newcastle, so it's really awesome that you guys have recognised that, so thanks.
Brilliant. Thank you very much, Simone.
Thank you.
Right, bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you very much, Alan. Appreciate it. Thank you. So, moving along.
We have now Best Government Solution of the Year, sponsored by Laughing Mind. Can we have Brian Hill up on stage, please?
Brian Hill, Laughing Minds, tell us, what's it about?
So Laughing Mind had its origins on a long walk through Nepal. Started off as an IT consulting company on the back of SMS consulting duties, and I've been running that since 2004, specialising in Atlassian system support. So we've got some clients here in the room, so fingers crossed for them, and we'll see how they go.
So do you start the morning with laughing classes?
I like to wake up with a smile.
So in this category, Best Government Solution of the Year, Lisa, we have...
Free Cuppa, Driver Campaign by Maroons. Fatigue is one of the three big killers on the New South Wales roads, and Free Cuppa is an application created to support the Free Cuppa, as named, for the driver. This campaign encourages drivers to take the time to arrive alive by stopping for a Free Cuppa at participating locations.
Community engagement, Port Stephens Council. We have connected organisations with over 70,000 members of their communities with almost 700,000 interconnections on that platform, including leaving comments, voting and sharing ideas through socially connected media.
Community engagement by Lake Macquarie City Council. It's a new community engagement tool where online ideas wall has been proved successful in encouraging users to post, share, and rate their ideas for the city's future. This innovative solution has taken the council forward in its work to make Lake Macquarie a city that is using new digital technologies as well as become more connected, innovative, and resilient. A truly smart city.
Okay, so.
Tough mix.
It is, and I mean, it's a very difficult area as well. Kind of, how do you measure the engagement of communities in that space? And I guess it's something that you guys are working on at Laughing Matters.
At Laughing Mind, we do a lot of government agency support. So a lot of our work is focused on service design and how we use some of the Atlassian platform stack to be able to support businesses in doing that. But I know that community engagement is a really tough call to try and pull off in terms of a technology platform. Yeah. Making sure you've got something that's nice, simple, responsive, light touch, able to be used through a range of devices. So let's see.
Okay, so.
Great. So presenting the award for Best Government Solution of the Year.
I'm not sure these guys have got enough feet to be able to take home another thong. Social Pinpoint, congratulations.
Hey, Social Pinpoint. Coming up to join us.
Congratulations.
Ah.
If you would like to hand that over.
Who is that one with? We serve as both of those clients. So thanks, guys. No, I won't use the
mic. No, please.
Okay. Yeah, I'll just say thanks. Social Pinpoints actually work with two of those clients that are up there, Lake Macquarie and Port Stephens. And I just want to say thanks to all our local clients, Newcastle as well, Newcastle local government here. We wouldn't be here if it wasn't for the local talent and the local support that we get. So thanks a lot. And if you've got any complaints with local government, get on Social Pinpoints platforms.
Yep.
And that's what we're here for. Cheers.
Your thong, wear it with pride.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you. Okay, so moving along.
So moving back to our next category, which is Best Online News Publication of the Year. Our nominees are surftork.com.au. It combines the written journalism of a magazine with video content, slideshows, and other digital enhancements to be much more immersive experience than just print or video can provide.
Then HUNTERhunter.com.au is all about revealing hidden treasures and secret gems, keeping up to date with all that's new and what's going on around Newcastle, Lake Macquarie, Port Stephens, and the Central Coast and the Hunter Valley. And they actually have some really good articles there too.
Of course, we also have the herald.com.au. And through an innovative web-focused staff, the Newcastle Herald's ability to deliver high-quality journalism has been recognized nationally and overseas through its digital platform.
I'm just passing over, and the winner is HUNTERhunter. Do we have the HUNTERhunter crew up here? Don't be shy. Come on, up you come.
Here we go.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you.
As someone with Hunter for a middle name, I feel like this must be HUNTERhunter. That's fantastic. I mean, so much talent lies here in the Hunter. Congratulations on your award.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
I can't believe we just won Best News. I didn't think we really were a news service, but if news is new bars, then that's us.
It's exciting. There's a lot happening in Newcastle, so we're not on.
I think we're out.
That's okay.
Do I keep going?
Yeah.
You can still talk to me.
I'll make it that much better.
All right, well, that's great.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Seriously, good job. I checked out the website. It looks fantastic.
Thank you.
Okay.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Brian.
HUNTERhunter.com.au. So as you can see, folks, I mean, the beauty of it is that being live streaming, can be a very, very challenging. And having produced in my earlier life live television at one stage, it is flying by the seat of your pants, so to speak. And I think to all of our crew here at Hunter TV and everyone else, and I need to remind everybody that effectively we're actually all volunteers up here tonight. And I think that's also indicative of the spirit that is in the Hunter, people just getting up and giving it a go. And I think that's what tonight's all about. So, turning to the last category in round one, we have, Lisa?
Best Social Media Solution Campaign of the Year.
So joining us here is Brendan Brooks, a very familiar face. Welcome, Brendan. Thanks, sir. Come up. Brendan. So, hypertext?
Hyperweb communications,
hyperweb. Yep. Now, actually, mate, you've actually been part of this whole movement, smart cities. In fact, I think you had some involvement in writing the position paper and so forth.
Nope.
I was wrong. Okay. But, I mean, effectively, you're also on that other side of understanding how communities work.
Yes, and I guess
in
some sense I have, you know, been involved in the digital business community for a good while now, from watching it, around the 2007, 2008 mark, I suppose, start to develop. And because I came from a government background, I was very interested in the power of the digital economy and how that can benefit regions as well as individual businesses. And it was something that I did try and adopt in my then role, and ended up in the process developing a digital-based business of my own.
Great, absolutely. And since this is the best social media solution campaign of the year category, tell us what your social media.
I don't know if you want to take my advice on social media exactly, but social media is still an important part of the of marketing kit for a business. There's a lot of hype around it, or there has been a lot of hype around it over the years, and that hype has probably started to drip off a little bit. But it's certainly the important part about social media is having a connection to your customer base, being available to your customer base, and communicating and keeping the conversation going about your product, and generating not just buyers, but, you know, fans and followers for your product.
Well said.
So the winner is, Brendan, if you'd like to announce it.
The winner of the best social media campaign solution is Guts Creative for their 2015 Newcastle International Animation Festival campaign.
And the decided interaction relayed on creation to get people really talking online. We created a local competition. Animate Daniel Johns and accepting the awards. Joining us, hello. Here he is, one thong. Okay. Come up closer, please, come in the light. So this is a fantastic event, because I saw that you actually got wrangled like cats, all these animators who are all at various different levels of expertise and so forth, to create this. So that must have been a really challenging and pretty scary environment, but clearly it worked, you know. How did you feel about it in the end?
It was amazing, I guess, because 37 animators donated their time to create this most incredible piece, and we can't thank them enough because their work was phenomenal. I guess it just shows what can be achieved through collaboration. So to everyone here, like, we'd love to work with you guys too, because we can achieve a lot together. So, and thanks to Kelly Bolton, who's the creative director, who's amazing, and thanks to Jane Shadbolt from the University of Newcastle, because we all work together to make it happen. So
where can you see the clip currently?
On YouTube and on YouTube. Facebook.
Yeah. Facebook. Yeah. Okay. So that's the Daniel Johns, and that was for his album, wasn't it?
Yeah. Track from his latest album, from Talk, Going on 16.
Going on 16. Yep. Thank you very much. Congratulations. Okay, guys, so at this stage, this is the end of round one. We have round two coming up. But why don't you enjoy the drinking, conversation, linking up with each other and discussing more, and we'll be back with you in the next 15 minutes. Thank you. My Big Tomorrow is a website designed to help young Australians realise bigger life choices. It's specifically created to help high school students in years 9 to 10 from low socioeconomic backgrounds to discover new career possibilities and learn the pathway to achieving them.
We also have eCoach by the Futura Group.
eCoach is a cloud-based solution. Courses are smartphone compatible. NEBYOD ready, meaning that students will be able to access courses at home, on the go or in the classroom. This build once and use anywhere approach means that eCoach can be easily paired with the popular tools like Google Classroom to transform teaching and learning in high schools.
Another nominee is Newcastle Herald School Newspaper Competition.
This is one after my heart. Newcastle Herald School Newspaper Competition gives primary and high school students an opportunity to don their journalistic caps. Students learn how to initiate, research, write, and compile stories and take photographs to gain a holistic understanding of the importance that accurate journalism plays in society.
Edify is also our nominee for Kinetic Information Systems.
Again, Australian schools are rich with student and school data in the form of demographics, perceptions, and learning results. As a result of working closely with proven technology partners and several thought leader schools, the groundbreaking EDI, designed to enhance student support and better engagement pairing and better engaging with parents. So, interesting, Hunter TAFE, you know, at the moment it's been enormous change. Some would say that we're not necessarily being the disruptors, but being disrupted. But what's your attitude, David?
Well, my attitude to this is Hunter TAFE has 55,000 students on its books right now. We offer over 600 courses. It's pretty safe to say that as a provider of vocational education and training in the Hunter, we would be looking after the majority of people in this domain. There wouldn't be a family in the Hunter right now that isn't touched by the delivery of Hunter TAFE. With regard to disruption, I'm looking at that as an opportunity. I'm looking at it as an opportunity because we're on the cusp of a technological revolution. The Internet of Things is smashing us right now.
in the global scale, provided we fully understand what our capability is and we align with industry needs, we're going to nail it. So I think the collaborative that we have here tonight, individuals that are represented in their own areas of expertise would understand this. And as long as my Hunter TAFE can align with the aspirations of business owners here, I think that we can nail it as well. So I hope I've answered this question for you.
Thank you, David. So David, would you like to announce the winner?
The best educational solution, the village of useful Newism for mybigtomorrow.com.au.
And coming up to accept the award, they're all chatting, they're trying to encourage them. Okay, come up, guys. Congratulations. So who would like to speak on behalf of Newism?
A few of us will speak on behalf of Newism.
Okay. Okay. This is becoming familiar. You guys were up here last year. Okay, so that's it. The selfies. So who'd like to speak on behalf of accepting the award?
Certainly.
This is clearly a collaborative.
Wow. This is absolutely a collaborative effort. My Big Tomorrow was a project by the Village of Useful and Newism, working in partnership with our client, the University of Newcastle. The project spanned about 12 months and for us was an absolute dream project to do. The university were amazingly trusting and confident in the project the whole way through, and what we've put together is something that we genuinely believe is going to make a difference to high school children in the Hunter and all around Australia. If you haven't seen My Big Tomorrow, the whole goal of the project and the website is to open up the minds of 15 and 16 year old high school students from low socioeconomic backgrounds, open up their minds to bigger life choices, to inform them, to educate them, and to inspire them about what their lives can become. So this is a project we took on with the University of Newcastle. It was launched in the Hunter, and we've seen it roll out really fast all across Australia. Just a couple of weeks ago, we were listed as one of five global finalists in a web design award for 2015 for best collaboration on the internet. And that, I think, is testament to the relationship that the village has with Newism, and this is another great collaborative project that we've done together. We love working with these guys, and I'm going to hand over to Wade from Newism.
Wade! Thanks, mate. I'd just like to echo everything Andy said. My Big Tomorrow project's been a dream project for us as well. It's definitely a pinnacle of the projects that we've worked on at Newism in our entire existence. These guys are fantastic to work with, and I'm really thrilled to work with them, and I'm really proud of everybody involved. And I just want to say thanks, guys. We did an awesome job.
Thank you.
I'd like to give you the award, the thong.
You might need this. I thought you're very well.
No, I've got nothing. Thank you very much. Congratulations. Thank you very much, David. Appreciate it. And thanks for your gun. Thank you.
Cheers,
mate. And of course, you may remember those guys were quite popular last year at the NEWi Awards in 2014. Now, Lisa, what do we turn to now?
Up next, we have the Best Health Solution of the Year. To present this award, we have Andrew McCullen from Digital Forage.
And Andrew's been doing a terrific job as our stage manager. Which have you stage managed before, Deb?
Can't you tell? No.
So, Andrew, Digital Forge. Yeah, lovely little play on words there. So were you a blacksmith at some stage?
No, weren't a blacksmith, but we did definitely discover that having a number in your domain name is a very bad idea. You have to spell it out to absolutely everyone. No, but no blacksmiths, just trying to belt great ideas or belt great products out of ideas.
Okay, now Lisa, what are the categories, who are the nominees and what have they done?
Great. So for the nominees, Hunter Health Kick by Newcastle Herald.
In its second year, the Health Kick innovated on the acclaimed 2014 program with the introduction of greater corporate support, a daily 5-minute challenge promoted through social media to offer an ongoing incentive. Hunter Health Kick offers a prototype of how far you can push and reach media organizations can achieve real change in their communities. Second category.
Our next nominee is Fine Sports.
Yeah, how about you tell us about this one?
Sure, absolutely. Fine Sports Cheering, aimed at getting everyone moving and active, this site gives people the chance to view a range of activities in one location. Normally, you would have to look for each activity individually, but with them, you can go to one site and view a whole wide range. We also have Stats One Smart Sports, and Stats One endeavors to bring 2015 technology to any young player who wishes to track and analyze his or her performance. This app collects football players' names and matches statistics. Using advanced visualization tools, these stats are displayed on the player's account in the Stats One web platform.
So, tell us, Andrew, who's the winner?
Okay, the winner for Best Health Solution is Smart Sports Solution for Stats One.
Stats One. Now, I heard a lot of noise there. Is anyone here to receive it? They're hugging, they're kissing. Come up, gentlemen.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
Thank you. Come into the light, gentlemen. Come into the light. So who are these fine gentlemen here?
Benjamin Remy.
Pierre Malou, CEO.
Keith Hallett.
So the incentive, what was the whole thing about this?
Right, the whole idea is to actually bring to young players, grassroots players, technology that is available today only to pro players. If you think about statistics, it's all across your TV network when you watch sports, but nothing is available to young players. Stats One is simply the first company in the world to bring advanced analytics to grassroots and youth players. We're specializing at the moment in football. We're coming into basketball, netball, and rugby in the next 6 months. We launched in Australia in August and just launched in the UK. And that emulation you get from your statistic, tracking your performance, brings more and more and more kids playing sport, or at least keeping working hard on their sports.
Thank you very much. Congratulations. Stats One Smart Sports. So now we turn to our fourth category in round two, which is?
Best website of the year. And we asked Alan Spicer from GrowthWise, or rather Superman Alan Spicer.
Thank you.
mybigtomorrow.com.au, University of Newcastle, Village of Useful and Newism. Now, after extensive market research and consultation with high school students, it was determined that there was a lack of useful resources available to help them understand career options. My Big Tomorrow was created to fill that void with inspiration, information, and education.
Home Cancer Research, from the Australian Cancer Research Foundation, STICI. The stated goal of the ACRF via the cancer research site is to end cancer by encouraging focused collaboration and innovative global ways of doing so. When launched, the websites were recognised as a world-first launch of a top-level domain by a not-for-profit organisation and the world's first ecosystem of sites for a TLD, or a top-level domain.
FindSportsEvents.com. The passion and aim is to expand the site right across Australia with more and more sports and fitness activities being added, with the obvious advantage in getting more people actively engaged in some form of physical activity and the great benefits that come from that.
And then again, somebody familiar, HUNTERhunter.com.au. We'll just come back here again. The founders saw a gap in the local market to provide a digital platform that showcased all of the great stuff that we're doing here in the Newcastle, apart from brewing beer. They took a capital city concept and localized it for Newcastle to reveal hidden treasures and those secret little gems.
Great. cce.sydney.edu.au, the University of Sydney Redback Solutions. The Centre for Continuing Education is a premier learning and education provider backed by the expertise of the University of Sydney and carefully selected educators who are industry experts in their fields.
And any more? Newcastleinspired.com.au, out of the square. The words for this site sum up what Newcastle Inspired is all about. There are many aspects of past, present and future that have and will shape our great city. We have much to learn from our past and much to be proud of as we go about our daily lives. This site, as it evolves, will collect footage, images and stories that go towards recording and showcasing what we feel makes up Newcastle Inspired. And Alan, what's the winner?
The best website by Redback Solutions for Sydney University website.
Sydney University, Redback. And to accept the awards, are we Skyping anyone in? No, no. Oh, they're here. Congratulations.
Kyle, very nice to meet you.
Kyle, thank you.
This is Jess.
Hello, Jess. Okay, guys, coming into the light. So tell us a little bit about your story and how did you get involved?
Well, we're the obviously a web company in Newcastle. We're a smaller company, but you know, we're very lucky to have the Centre for Continuing Education, Sydney Uni, come to us looking for, you know, a bit of a rebrand. And they've honestly been an amazing client. We've never worked with, you know, someone quite as flexible as them. They gave us free rein and basically just let us do what we want. We couldn't be more grateful. And honestly, to be standing here is blows my mind, to be honest. We're amongst some fantastic competition. And to say I'm unprepared to accept this is probably an understatement. But we're just very grateful to the Lunatic Society for this award. This is, in fact, actually our first ever awards night. We've never submitted a site before. So to be standing here to accept this, we're incredibly grateful and very, very proud to be here tonight.
Thank you very much. So you guys are a team, you know, both in life and in work?
Just work.
Just work. Well, congratulations. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
There you go. And thanks to GrowthWise and our Superman, Alan Spicer. So, turning to the last category in round two, we have
Best Cloud Solution of the Year. It's sponsored by SoftLayer, and we asked Brendan Yell to come up.
Hey
Link Mobility Platform, BMP, a mission to solve the problems faced by government and enterprises when needing to harness mobile, cloud, and other emerging technologies into existing legacy business systems. The goal being to quickly but properly architect solutions that can transform an unlimited number and a range of business processes.
Social Pinpoint connected organizations to over 70,000 members of their communities with almost 700,000 interactions on its platform, including leaving comments, voting, and sharing ideas through connected social media.
Hey Tradie, bringing tradies and their customers a lot closer together. A tradie can invoice with one hand while packing up his van and be paid before he pulls out of the customer's driveway. The job is truly finished end to end.
House Nexus, a cloud service that helps people understand their financial position with their property to make better decisions. It uniquely also connects them to their advisor to support existing professional relationships, allowing data to be shared between both parties without the need for hard copy spreadsheets to be emailed around.
Club Evolution by Newism. Club Evolution is an online service designed to help car owners minimize the hassle of car maintenance by keeping track of the motorist's vehicle services at participating service centers and a record of the roadside assist callouts. With better insight into their customers and the vehicles, customers are offered a better level of care and maintain a more consistent client base.
Okay. So, Brendan, who's the winner?
And the winner of the flip-flop is Blink Mobile.
For the Blink Mobility platform. And up to accept the award. Ah. Okay. So from soft layers, novelty check. So it's $120,000 of server time. So Brent, tell us, what does that actually mean?
Well, apparently this cloud thing is getting very, very popular now. I think everyone's doing it. But basically, they for 12 months, you get up to $120,000 of cloud computing from SoftLayer. So if you don't know SoftLayer, we host some of the biggest apps in the world, Fitbit, WhatsApp, MailChimp, SendGrid. And these guys, I think, will hopefully make good use of it.
So you could do a lot with this, I imagine.
Absolutely. This will go to, this will be exceptionally well used, I can assure you. This is fantastic. Yeah.
And the novelty check.
And the novelty check.
Novelty. It has, but it hasn't been dated. Some of that remains, it will be. Thank you very much.
No, thank you.
Would you like to say any words about who you'd like to, in terms of support or how you feel about where your company's going?
Well, just very quickly. I mean, the introduction was pretty comprehensive, and we're a Central Coast-based company. Very pleased to be here. Very pleased to be considered, and the win is fantastic. We've picked up a couple of awards this year, but this definitely will have pride of place on our mantelpiece, I can assure you. So thanks again, everybody.
Thank you, Ryan. Congratulations. There go the classes. Well, that brings to the end round two. So again, just watch those glasses out there. The floor is hard. There's no bounce to it. And we'll bring you back. See you in another 10 minutes. Thank you. Now, some housekeeping. It's a little bit of a boring bit. This is take notes. Remember your university days, guys, or wherever you may have been. The bar will be closing at 10 a.m. The bar will be closing at 10 a.m. And we need to be heading out of here by 10:30. Okay, however, we will be kicking on at the landing. So come and join us. Perhaps you can buy us, Lisa and myself, a drink, okay? There on the honeysuckle foreshore, just around the corner. Now, in this category, we are looking at the best online video of the year. And I'd like to invite Graham Keddy from XCXO to join us here on the stage.
And the nominees are Newcastle Reservoir number 1 out of the square. Situated on the corner of Tyrell and Brown Streets and built in 1882, it was the first water reserve in the Hunter. The video enables those who may not be able to tour the reservoir physically to experience the unique historical asset of our great city.
The Anzac Memorial Walk out of the square on April 25, 2015, people experienced the Anzac Day along the Newcastle Anzac Memorial Walk for the very first time, delivering a mixture of beauty, achievement, appreciation, and a genuine heartfelt emotion. Out of the Square took on the initiative of capturing this significant moment in Newcastle and the Hunter region's history.
Great. We also have The Cleanest, Season 2. The Cleanest have been featured on a number of international media outlets and also plays on the Info TV channel in the UK and Ireland. The Cleanest Season 2 consisted of 10 episodes and the series was made right here in Newcastle.
And then we also have the Daniel Johns going on 16, which was Guts Creative, and also Little Mike Listen Up, submitted by Rolling Ball Productions. Okay, I'd like to turn to who's taking out this year? Best video.
So best online video goes to Rolling Ball Productions, including Steve Pavlosky, April Howard, Phil Jennings, Luke Pippen, Lil, and Makita Douglas. For Lil, Mike, listen up.
Thank you. Steve, you want to join us? And congratulations. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Well done. Okay, guys, now this was a big challenge because this was to address the issues of health in Aboriginal communities, particularly among young Aboriginal people who are very, very difficult to engage. So, Steve, tell us a bit more about it.
Thank you. First of all, thanks to the Lunatic Society. Just to tell you a little bit about the subject of this video clip, Professor Kelvin Kong up at the Hunter is the only Aboriginal surgeon in the country. So when I heard that, I was like, got to be involved in this. It's basically to educate young Aboriginal kids to check their ears and tell their parents if they've got a problem, because it can cause a huge shift in their lives if they can hear. And according to Professor Kong, who's had a lot to do with people in jails in the Hunter, a lot of Indigenous men in jail, if you trace their history back, you might have been able to change their path. So I think it's an absolutely worthy cause. We made it, Rolling Ball made it. This is Paul Donnelly from Rolling Ball. April Howard produced the film.
You directed it.
I directed it. It was a full-on collaboration. So we had an Indigenous rapper, Little Aby, Luke Pittman with Makita Douglas from A Wobbuckle actually wrote the lyrics, which I, you know, just cast an eye over. And Phil Jennings, an animator, just nailed it. So thank you very much. And I just wanted to say a word about April and Rolling Ball, and apropos what someone else said up here tonight, that creating when you've got freedom and trust is just the most enjoyable thing in the world. And then if you get paid for it on top of that, it's sensational. So thank you very much. Oh, and my beautiful wife, who puts up with me and inspires me. That was close. That was super close. Woo-hoo. Love you, doll.
Thanks, Steve. And thank you very much, Steve. Guys, well done, Rolling Ball. The clip you'll be able to find through the Lunatics link too, but they have their Vimeo profile as well. And thank you very much to Graham Kitty. Now, turning to second of this installment.
Up next, we have the Best Tech Startup of the Year category.
Thank you.
have Deki. Now, Deki is a trip advisor for boating, an online marketplace for boating services. Deki aims to help boat owners find and hire the best local marine businesses and provide a simple solution for businesses to win more customers online.
And continuing that theme of the construction and boats and so forth, Yewin. Yewin.com is a new website built for the construction industry. It simplifies the life of people needing construction information, products, or services through the use of social networks, marketplace, technology integrations.
We also have BusyVid. BusyVid is the world's fastest corporate video production system with the simplicity of an easy-to-use app. It allows organizations to build flexible corporate video libraries and repurpose content at the point of use with a flexibility that was unimaginable in the old non-linear video world.
PayTrady. PayTrady is a mobile solution for small businesses, invoicing and payments, including automatic payment due notifications. The web app provides integration between smartphone, tablet and PC, helping small businesses stay on the job and not get behind their desks. Tradies can get on to the spot without the need for a merchant account.
We also have Smart Sports. Fans can engage with their idols online and on the mobile app. Pro teams spend hundreds of thousands, if not millions of dollars in advanced analytics. I mean, analytics is the discovery and communication of meaningful patterns in data, enabling to make decision-making aids, which lead to sports lead to game plans and specific training and development of skills.
And finally, we have Switched In. Switched In is a building internet of energy platform of preference for residential, commercial, solar, and battery storage. The company leverages the scalability and the computational capabilities of cloud solutions to create economies of scale to offer these features that it has not previously been possible in this market. And also, just before everyone disappears, we'd just like to remind winners to go to the media wall, which is just outside, so we can get some photographs. So, who's the winner?
And the winner is Switched In, Andrew Mears.
All right. Andrew, is it?
Yes, okay. Okay, fantastic.
Congratulations. What was the inspiration?
The inspiration is to try to make the clean energy more democratic and to help build new businesses.
And I guess at the moment you would be very excited about some of the work that Tesla's doing and sort of being able to supply batteries in walls. I mean, is there a way that you'd be integrating in that area?
Absolutely. I mean, you know, this has really transformed things. This year, the price of batteries has halved. And, you know, that's just, if you're looking for examples of disruptive technologies that are happening right now in our world, that's right there, man. That's really something.
Well, congratulations. I hope we'd like to see a lot more from this, and certainly I think 2015, 2016 is a very exciting world for batteries. Congratulations. Thank you, Andrew.
Great. Thank you very much. That's amazing.
Well done. And thank you very much, everyone. At Foresight. And we will ship off the thong to you over there. Thanks, Andrew. Okay, moving along.
As we're winding down the night, the next category we have is the best digital agency of the year. The nominees are Newism,
and to present the award, we have our federal member, Clayton. Thank you very much. How are you?
Thank you.
Sharon Clayton is up here. Now, it's very interesting times at the moment. Is there a new wind blowing through Canberra?
It's never dull in Canberra, but I am super excited to be home in Newcastle. And just before, I know everyone's really keen to get this agency award on record, but I do want to say a really huge thank you to the Lunatic Society for hosting these awards year after year, because the work that you do in nurturing the digital economy in Newcastle, the new, emerging, and indeed the very best of digital economy here, is really greatly appreciated. And huge thanks to everybody in the room, everybody who's a nominee tonight. It's it really heartens me when I go down to Parliament to know that I get to represent such a brilliant community. So thank you.
Thank you very much, Sharon. So, if you'd like to take the thong, and underneath the thong is the envelope, and the winner is?
And the winner is Newism.
The Oscars kind of assembly. Where are they? Newism. Come on, guys. Come on, you're the new players in the scene. Congratulations.
Oh, thank you.
Nice to meet you.
Who's going to take the phone?
I remember it, that you.
Okay. Like to say a few words, or?
I'd love to say a few words. Thank you. Wow, this is a huge deal for us. We're stoked, absolutely stoked. So thank you very much, everybody. Huge thanks to Gordon and the Lunatic Society. They do a great deal for the local industry, and they deserve a huge round of applause. So thank you. Thanks to our awesome partners at the Village of Useful. It's so fantastic working with you guys. Working on the My Big Tomorrow project was the best project we've worked on in our careers, and it's been awesome to work with you guys, so thanks a lot. Thanks to our awesome clients like Decky, for example. Decky's picked up an award tonight. It's great to work with great local companies like Decky, so thanks to them. And I guess most importantly, thanks to our awesome team. They're all fantastic. They're all experts at what they do. And it's a pleasure to come to work with them most days. Anything to say?
Wives.
Oh, and of course, thank you to our long-suffering, wonderful wives who have supported us through our 8 years of business. And without them, we would be nothing. Thanks a lot, guys.
Thank you very much.
Cheers.
Thank you. Cheers, thank you. And thank you very much to Sharon Clayton. Now, at this stage, we turn to a very, very important award. This is one where we get our erstwhile head honcho, head man, so to speak, Gordon Whitehead, to come up and present the Joe Award, which is actually in memory of a very dear and very passionate person who believed in this place, in this city, and the people who are here. Gordon, here you are. What's the history of the Lunatics, mate?
Basically, Lunatics came from the Lunar Society of Birmingham, which was founded in 1765, during the Industrial Revolution. They came together just to have a talk about the effects of the change then, and also the innovation and experimentation. And we decided to do the same. We saw lots and lots of talent, and we thought we needed a platform where people share ideas. So that's where it was born. And that was commonly known the Lunatics, so that's what we took.
Excellent. So Gordon, tell us, who is the winner of the Joe Award?
Well, the Joe Award is actually, we give it out each year to either an individual talent that's shone this year, or an organization or a company that we feel, or the management committee feels, has supported the digital ecosystem. So this year, because their work with Slingshot and they've opened up their customer base to new startups. We've decided to give the Joe Award this year to NRMA. So, Deborah Ann.
Yeah, it's such an honor to get this award. It's difficult sometimes, I think, for the startups and the scale-ups to understand what it's like to work with a corporate, and we've got lots of lessons to learn, but we've loved working with Slingshot. They've given such professionalism and care and nurturing to the startups and scale-ups, and I have to say for us as well at NRMA. So thank you so much for the award. Appreciate it.
Thank you, congratulations. We just want to thank all our volunteers, as well as congratulations to our winners as well as finalists. Winners, after the round, please go to the media wall and have your photo taken as well.
And we also like to say thank you to all the sponsors who very kindly gave time, energy, and effort and contributed hard cash to the event. I really appreciate it, and to you. It's only you, by being here, make it happen and present, and we'll be hopefully seeing you all and more in 2016. Also, if you in some way feel you can contribute to the community by getting involved with the Lunatics, more than welcome. We're always looking for supporters and volunteers, so don't hesitate, put your hand up. So again, a reminder, the landing, we'll all be out of here at 10:30. Enjoy your final drinks, and thank you very much again to coming to the NEWi Awards 2015. Thank you.